I mean, as you can see, he is a level 30 Enigma. He is known for this hero. It is his signature. He's kind of the, one of those players, and I feel like this actually applies to a fair number of European players, is that the you just like spam a certain hero, you get really, really good at that hero, and then you move on to the next one. And Enigma is one of his favorites, so I'm sure he's played this matchup before. I'm just interested to see what he does. You just like deny the range creep and then throw the conversions into the jungle somewhere, or what?
You can just play to deny a bunch, I guess. It's probably pretty annoying. You can play to like go to his side and steal his small camp, some stuff like this. That's the kind of stuff I would like to see. I think it's the highest impact if you can get away with it. I'm just not sure how reliable it is into this acid spray spam, because I don't think the Eidolons can just tank acid spray that easily, especially in an aggressive situation. He is the Enigma expert, so if anyone knows about this stuff, it's him. I'm sure he has an idea. Normally I also see him sometimes go Vessel on this mid Enigma.
Yep.
Which looks pretty good this game, unless Necro, but I guess Necro's going for it. So I'm also interested to see what he decides to go items-wise, because normally I would say it's Vessel 100%. But of course, the Vylama's picking that up.
Early
he's going to go
packed?
Something else. Potentially, yeah. He could just go the Vlads, buff the Eidolons, try and play around those. I don't know if it's applying enough pressure in the game. I guess you can play super fast with Slaughter Amp, try and do some early Roshans and stuff. It would help with that. Could just go Octarine Rush. That could be spicy, you know.
Oh, they're actually going to fight for this one. This is going to be a little spicy. Divine Llama has tons of Poison Touch stacks. Costa Bile is going to be able to keep his distance. They have to fight together, but they're kiting him around. And eventually, he will take out. He's going to get off the Battery Assault, but it will not be enough. He does lose Divine Llama's life first, so Husky gets the first blood. Alex does manage to get the counter kill onto Husky, but still, to the favor of Noun, certainly.
Pretty decent. Did cost his Kunk a lot of regen, whereas Necro's gonna come back full, and first blood of the Dazzle. Much rather have it on the Kunk in this situation.
Look at Gunner go! He's diving behind the tower just to try and kill all the Eidolons, and I think he just got all three.
Well, that's a decent start for him, CS-wise. Little bit of inflation.
Yeah, certainly.
Never hurt anybody, right?
Yeah, it's not a problem, I'm sure. Oh, nice torrent land. That's going to be the poison touch. Reapplying again and again. Divine Llama is being super pressured. And I feel like this is a lane that Necrophos should be able to do fine once he gets to, like, level 3. I feel like this hero kind of operates like Timbersaw would or Dragonite. But this level 1 pressure is really kicking him out.
Level 1 is the best time to abuse this hero. It's when he's the weakest. If you can build up a decent level advantage, send him to base once off of death or something, you're definitely going to be pretty happy. And I think Dazzle is a hero that can definitely apply the early pressure.
Ooh, it is just getting too close. Gunner keeps on pressuring Rudy and keeps on going for the Eidolons. Took a couple of tower hits, though, and dropped dangerously low.
He's getting Malifist.
Yeah, he's not going to die, though. He's got the Fairy Fire still. Rudy had to burn his earlier.
I wonder if he's not. Does he go bottle on mid Enigma that often? I feel like he doesn't.
I don't think so, no.
So just playing off the region. I mean, he's fairing out of clarity.
He's going for the kill on the Gunner. Gunner thinking he can fight the Eidolons, but he can't. The Fairy Fire keeps him alive, but the last hit comes in. It's not quite enough. Gunner also out of South coming in. Rudy will die inside the Acid Spray. Took a couple hits from the tower with the minus armor on him. He's going to miss a full wave. Ooh, that was a close call, but Gunner comes out the big winner of that one.
The Fairy Fire debates, man. Always get you in the end. That's a rough death, because he missed basically a wave and a half almost.
Yeah.
And it's extra gold for Alk, who was otherwise maybe in a rough position with how much resources he used.
Oh dear, that's going to make things real awkward. It also can feel good when you're standing in for a team and something like that happens, you know?
I mean, let's not put top too lane, much pressure on
Costa. Shallow Grave. Let's see if they can get the damage in to finish him off, and they will. The Vialama hits him right as the Shallow Grave expires, and all of a sudden his lane is back into form. I mean, he was getting crushed earlier by the Poison Touch, but now he's good.
Didn't get the Urn Charge, but he got the extra regen off that last hit.
Yep.
And like you said, he's catapulted to the top. Now this lane is going to get pretty tough.
Nice toss back. Z-Freak gets the kill onto Sam for that. Eve might actually be able to get the counter kill, but no. Shikuchi was up.
He's going to get chipped back here, too. At least a little bit. So, I think Wildcard, honestly, pretty happy with how this lane phase is going overall. All three of their cores are pretty much farming. You had, like, this one kind of pseudo bad death mid, but I think top is going pretty well for them. I think that level one room fight actually wasn't that bad in hindsight. I think it looked bad because you're giving away first blood, but the end result was Clock got a solo XP kill, which put him to level basically halfway to level two before the lane started, which is super big for this hero.
Right.
And then he kind of just like battled the early waves on his own through this dazzle to get his Necro to where he is now. I don't know, some of these rune fights, they work out weirdly, and I've often thought, like, if you're more confident in a lane, then you just shouldn't get sucked into them at all, because the less chaos, the better for a lane that you're trying to win.
Oof. Gutter continues to be pressured. I mean, even though he got that kill, he is behind in net worth by, like, 200 behind this Enigma, and he's getting pushed out of lane before he gets level 6. Top lane, Costa in trouble again. Alex managed to catch him inside of the cogs with battery assault. Looks like he might die, but the Shallow Grave, Divine Llama, doesn't even bother trying to go for the kill with the Death Pulse.
Necro versus a melee hero. You love to see it, or you hate to see it. Depends who you are in the lane.
Yeah, it depends on which side of the matchup you're on. Black Hole mid lane. Gunner already has the Chemical Rage, but it's going to be a close call. Looks like it's going to be close, but he barely is going to live. Top lane again. They managed to pressure Costa, and this time they do get the kill. Husky had Shallow Grave still on cooldown. They trade out kills, but importantly, kill the enemy carry.
Yeah, this mid lane is a nice edge, man.
Oh, Gunner bottom lane, they're going to be able to get Z-Freak. It looks like Eve finishes him off, but the bug is on Eve. Very awkward. Sam's going to commit to be able to kill the bug, but Shikuchi is going to be able to run him down pretty easily. So Moose survives. Earn charge
here
on himself. Let's see if he could juke out Eve. The crush. Maybe a bash first, then the crush, then a couple more hits. Does manage to get Shikuchi out of range. The sentry almost got him killed.
Still some decent exchanges going Wildcard's way, especially his top lane is getting a little out of control with how much the Vialama is getting away with it. He's going to have a very fast vessel in this game, which is extremely strong versus these tanky melee cores. Now he's want to be able to frontline. If that hole had killed the Alc mid, it would have been really big for him. Gunner knows his limits.
Nice two-man crush. Eve fighting again out with Moo. He will lose that engagement, but they still get the trade-off, so Sam gets some solo experience at least. Top lane, Husky being caught inside of the cogs. There's the torrent, and Husky will be able to Shallow Grave, but can't seem to quite get himself away from that clockwork until it's perhaps too late. Yeah, the Vialama finished him off. The Death Pulse was enough.
Rocket Flare to pop the raindrop for the Death Pulse to seal his fate.
Oh, that's
more
clever.
Regen. More regen going this Necro's way. He is out of control at this point. And that is going to be an issue. Because this Necro destroys a lot of their heroes in this game.
They're Moo coming into the mid lane to be able to gank up Rudy with Z-Free coming in from behind. Now Gunner is already low enough, and they're going to be able to get the Reaper Zeit to finish him off. The Enigma dies, yes, but now Alex is here, snuck up on Z-Free, caught him inside the cogs, and they get a second kill for that. So Nouns, they're the ones setting up that gank, but Wildcard, with a very fast response, gets the better of the engagement.
Reaper charge online, Alchemist in the grave. Can't ask for much more.
Is under attack.
Where did this game come from? Let me ask you that, Captain.
I was going to say the same thing.
I've been watching a lot of NA recently. I'm not going to lie, a lot of these games, pretty slow early games, a lot of farm action. This is like, is this Dota 3 Brawl Bros or something? I mean, what's going on?
Yeah, I mean, well, for whatever reason, it seems like the top two dogs of NA, playing slow. And that's what, I mean, EG is kind of known for that as well. But then you go down to the next tier, Nouns and Wildcard, and they're just running at each other.
Dire's top tower is under attack. I mean, I hope your ob skills are up to par. You're going to be getting flamed a lot this one.
We've caught almost every kill. In fact,
okay.
Sam, Avalanche, we've caught every kill in this game. I think I've only missed like two or three kills all day, all right? Give me some
credit. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. I'll give you 0.2 of a credit.
Yeah, I missed that first blood earlier. The Dawnbreaker versus Puck. I didn't expect it.
Yeah, what about
Black
this
Hole, mid lane, Eve.
Round two.
Lending his damage and his corrosive haze, the Eidolons are actually doing a good amount of work to Gunner. I was not expecting this matchup to go this way, and I'm not sure Gunner expected it either.
He's playing so aggressive on it. I feel like he can just farm, like, stack small, push the lane in, farm. He's trying to really push the limit and kill these Eidolons. He's paid the price a couple times. I think he's underestimating how much damage the Cyril does with, like, the early levels.
Hey, what do you think about Sam's build, real quickly? He went 3-1-1 instead of 1-3-1.
Yeah, I think it's good.
Okay.
This lane I have been experimenting with as well. I think this Wyvern from 5 really benefits from the extra Arctic Burn levels instead of Blast. Especially if you're in a game where you're just skirmishing on tanky heroes. Mm-hmm. You don't always have a reliable Splinter Blast target. Your Arctic Burn is cheaper for the amount of damage it does. You get extra slow, you get extra slow, which is really big. You get extra uptime, which is really big. It's just a better all-around spell. So if your aim in the game is just to fight and not shove waves as much, then I think this build is pretty strong.
Okay.
Which seems to be the motto of this game, you know?
Hookshot in, trying to defend Divine Llama, who is gonna die.
Stick.
Did not get off the stick. He had a Fairy Fire in there as well. I mean, that was a huge turnaround. He might have been able to get the Reaper Scythe on Mu. Maybe kills the Tiny. A potential double kill, but instead just falls a little bit short.
He wanted to get that Shroud off before the heal, but not enough time to jam it all in. And like you said, pays the price. A very big death. He's the highest net worth hero in this game. Arguably had the best laning phase. Dire's top tower is under attack. Nouns gonna be happy to pick that one up. Maybe more.
Alex, that was so much damage. The level 1 Shadow Wave combined with the Tiny Confusion. A big kill. Another one. Divine Llama's gonna try and help out here. Two-man crush and a little bit of heal. They throw out the Winter's Curse, not the best one. Seafreak, no targets around him.
Here.
They probably could have killed Seafreak, but yeah, you're right. Can't really throw it down when the Dazzle's somewhere in the fight.
Yeah, he's going to have to think about it this game. Another reason why Dazzle's pretty decent versus Hero, any type of save versus that Reaper. I mean, it's the easiest grave of your life. You got like 1.5 seconds to think about it. Nice
hook shot. Ooh, push back with the cogs, and they get him. Now Husky, who is trying to run in to get the Shallow Grave. Doesn't get it, and instead we'll be on the receiving end of that Reaper Scythe.
Can't save yourself.
No, you can't. And, I mean, Alex is having one hell of a game on this Clockwork. I feel like he's just setting up kills nonstop.
Pretty nice areas to fight in for him as well. These, like, random jungle skirmishes where this hero shines. Nothing to tank up the battery. Gets to isolate some hero. Set it for the rest of his team. Yeah, he's pretty chilling. And remember, this hero can farm now too. You get an early Soul Ring, some mana regen item. You can even go Orchid Rush on 4 o'clock. Start killing them creep camps with the extra battery assault. He could really accelerate.
Trying to find Alex. Don't get close enough for the X. We now have the Relic up on Gunner, but it is going to be a very delayed Radiance at this point.
He's catching up fast. That is the Alchemist special. No care lane, only care good neutral spawns.
I guess so.
Which, you know, he gets some Dark Troll summoner camps, he's gonna be pretty happy with that. The big question is, what is Mu's progression in this game? I feel like we talk a lot about Nouns, in particular Mu having high impact on the game, and he's having a rough one. There's another fight Bowl is up, working on Enigma, actually.
Really good avalanche, but the Orchid is going to stop the tiny toss back, and it looks like they're just going to leave Alex behind. Never mind, Alex has his own escape.
Never leave a man behind.
The hook shot to the Enigma gets him away. The man Husky, curse. I mean, he was diving in deep after this Enigma, and he will pay a certain price for it. They're going to have to chase him back. They want to be able to get the kill, and they're not going to be able to. Eve came in from the side, the toss-up straight in the air, but it looks like he should be able to collect on the tiny kill. Maybe a Reaper's Scythe? Not really necessary.
Now you dwell. Fast Orchid bailing out that toss-back. We were wondering where Rudy is going to go. Radiant's top tower is Extra under Silence attack. Is what he's chosen, and this item's powerful in mid-Enigma. You get it very fast. Combine it with Malifus, Eidolon's hitting you. Suddenly this Weaver, he's going to be food for the chopping, a long portion of this game. You ever Sakuchi in and get caught, you're just dead. There's only so many targets this Dazzler can grave. You know, the second he uses Grave on a Weaver or something, someone else is getting Reapered. I like the item decision. It's gonna apply a lot of map pressure here for a decent amount of time.
Eve also going pretty aggressive route here with the Mask of Madness into the Blink Dagger. Very similar build from what we saw with Leslau's Slardar in the offlane. And really, there's no other build, I think, to go on a Slardar. Maybe you go BKB before Blink. But...
the only other one that comes to mind would be a Midas.
Yeah,
which sure. I've seen Amar build Midas on Zero once or twice. How situational it is, I'm not sure. I think on Carry Slaughter, it's more interesting if you're having like a super good game. Just guarantee that scaling gold income. Coin. That said, this Mask of Madness build is—it's not like you're farming slow at all, you know.
Yeah.
This item's basically a Midas in itself. How fast you can clear through camps and ancients and do all the things a normal carry does. So it's keeping up pretty decently.
Gunner is beginning to make a little bit more of a network gap between him and second place. It's still wild card ultimately up in overall net worth, but Alchemist is beginning to get some serious farm, working towards the BKB. But again, wild card don't really seem too pressured to try and shut him down. Everybody's farming.
I don't even think they're too pressured in this game. Like, they have decent answers to Zalk, Black Hole, a Scythe, the Slardar amp, not to mention this Wyvern. If he gets farmed, like Sammy Boy's playing the four this game, if he gets farmed, don't be surprised to see some Aether into Ags or something. Like, it owns this game. I think it's actually viable on some of these support Wyverns. Block getting voted.
Hook shot out onto an ally. Z-Freak actually spotted here with a Corrosive Haze on him. Sam, check the high ground for a second there.
Just wanted the Scythe.
He wanted it.
Didn't get it.
Still only two stacks for him.
Rudy. Going bug hunting.
Yeah.
I mean, this Weaver. Again, I was going to say, like, I feel like the games where Mu is kind of sad are the hard ones for now. He's like their primary shot caller. He's the drafter. This is the guy with the vision for the game, right? And I feel like this is another one of those games. He just seems out of place for me. It's like, what is his role in the game, you know? He's a Weaver, he's farming, he has a vessel with zero charges. This is like a very skirmish-based hero. He wants to be fighting right now. This is where his hero's super strong, with the early bugs, Max Akuchi, the vessel rush. Doesn't feel like he's finding footing, though. Which is, it makes me worried for this Nalz lineup. I don't think this Alc can just solo carry this game. He keeps getting Dark Troll Summoners, maybe he can. I mean, this guy's got some good RNG, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, and he's almost at that BKB, and it feels like to me you're saying Nouns need to make a pretty good splash with that item timing.
Based on how this game's going, yes. I think they want to fight with it. They need to get this Weaver going. They need to use this Kunkka strength. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. It's hard for him. But you gotta find some opening here.
Alright, Blink Dagger on the Tiny. Mu still just sitting on a Spirit Vessel, so nothing new there. If they want to farm another 5 minutes or so, they can get Blink on Gunner and finish up a BKB on Costa as well. And that, I feel like, is would be like this huge window of like really, really strong dire side action. But it is just more time. That wild card is just kind of seeming like very content. Slardar's getting nice and big. Enigma, like, as you said, they have all the answers to an Alchemist. They don't have to worry about this hero that much.
Yes, I think you want to fight it here now. I don't think you wait for this Kunkka BKB. He went bots. It's the greedier build. Okay, I can see a payoff long term. But you cannot delay the fight this much, especially with Tiny Blink coming out. You need to get your Tiny and Weaver enabled in this game. They are not going to keep up on the map with how they itemize the skirmish if you're just watching three of these wild card cores just farm it up. I mean, you're just putting all your eggs in this Alchemist basket, which, I mean, he's a decent basket to put your eggs in. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. I just don't see him 1v3ing this game in terms of the core's output. Not to mention, like, this Wyvern can even screw with him, too. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. And there's a Roshan for the Slaughter.
It's free. I mean, the Nouns is being so hesitant. They're kind of poking at this mid tower, just sitting around, and Wildcard's like, okay, you're gonna do that. We're going to do Roshan. Now we have an Aegis on a Slardar. Your timing for fighting, which we were just talking about, is now kind of gone.
Wyvern ult didn't find anything. And yeah, this is just an awkward position for now. It's like, are you going to run into these heroes? Seems pretty hard. Gunner says I'm down for it, though.
Does have the vision behind the tower. They know about it as a result. The Chemical Rage is down. That's why Alex is going to jump in. Reaper Scythe is going to be bailed out by the Shallow Grave. But still, Gunner is low enough that Divine Llama could get that kill. Fortunately, the Avalanche covers him up. Eve, Splinter Blast. He still has the BKB going, but Eve is looking to be able to catch up. And the sprint is almost up. He's silenced a little bit longer. The Mask Madness is now down, but he doesn't want to go for it. Not underneath the tier 2. Ultimately, they will miss out on that kill. But it looks like Dazzle did get run down at the end.
And that's where you wish you had that axe, right? Just chop them?
Yeah.
They still have hole, though, and not much used. I mean, the Reaper, okay, your Reaper trading for this Alchemist BKB, it's not the worst in the world, because there's no way this Alch can ever fight without it.
Yeah.
So you're not losing too much on the map, even in these types of exchanges, and of course, Alch's missing his timings here. Tiny Weaver trying to make something happen. I just get turned on. Yeah.
I'm not sure what their thought process was there. I'll be honest,
that
Avery.
That was not the play. That was not the play.
You toss in a Necrophos, who's already tanky, and you toss it into a Weaver, who only does physical damage. So.
Yeah, he still has no vessel charges, so he's having a rough one.
Yeah.
I understand the frustration, though. They feel like they need something to happen in this game. I think they're just not sure where and how.
Mm-hmm.
Chill, baby. That was not wise. I mean, this is tier 2 top, Aegis. Signature Aegis off Roshan into tier 2 into outpost. It's a classic move. And tower is under attack. All this is, it's getting time for Rudy to get the BKB here. Which, what is stopping the BKB hole?
Not a damn thing.
That's right. Not a goddamn thing. So, what's to stop him just BKB holing out every fight and then... Alright, you grave him, but how do you turn that fight afterwards?
Alex contested the power runes, did get a haste rune, and thought, maybe I can play with these two. His allies, though, are a little bit too far away. They're still focused on getting this mid-tier 2, and Nouns are going to try and defend it. Radiant's bottom tower is
under attack. I don't know if there's much defending it. Eidolons, they're just taking it for free. They are going to try and fight, though. Alright, this is a good kill.
Pick off on the clockwork, but that's all they're going to get, it seems.
Let's get vessel charges. Finally.
That's true, yeah.
Feels like he's been hunting for these for 10 minutes here.
Yep.
It does give them an extra 2 versus. I mean, in the time he's been hunting for him, this Necro's built in a Yule's in another 1400, so. this vessel might not even get that much use this game.
Orchid Reaper, jeez! That was a fast move, but a nice one. Gets a pick off on the Weaver, and a little bit more time. Wear it downs. The clock is ticking for them. They're going to try and get an AC next on to Gunner. Costa, I mean, he had his BKB. I don't even know what his next item could be.
I don't know. Nullifier, Abyssal,
Silver Edge,
Bloodthorn. I feel like they need some damage.
Yeah, they
do. Some kind here. At least some other damage source. I guess you can go like the Ags Torrent Storm Shard build. Doesn't seem great though. The Silver Edge I'd be okay with. Maybe you can find some pickoffs.
Leading off, Eve. He's got a BKB. Doesn't actually pop it right away, so Seafreak does get some spells off. The Winter's Curse on the side didn't really hit a whole lot either, so... Could have been a Dream Initiation for Wildcard. Goes a bit awry, and Nouns will be able to get away pretty much scot-free. Rudy's not even here, though, so...
He's chilling. He is almost a BKB. He's cruising. That Wyvern's ult almost hit multiple people. That was very close. Unfortunately, he misses.
Oh, Z-Freak.
Looking.
Jumps a little bit too far forward and doesn't get the pickoff he was hoping for. The Shallow Grave is there, though. It's going to be able to buy him enough time. He's goes for the TP out.
Hook
and
shot,
he does
interrupt.
Manage to get a hook shot, interrupt. Tavai is going to be able to heal up. And now Gunner just has to use his BKB. But he can't even go for a TP out. They don't even necessarily need this black hole, it looks like. He will manage to blink away. Stopped any damage coming his way, so... Still no black hole to be used, but that just means a darker sign for Nouns. They're losing fights without that team fight ability being used.
Just so hard to initiate, unless you get some really good toss back. Even if you do, your Tiny is likely going to pay the price. And this Wyvern's causing them all kinds of problems here. They can't jump the back line. Rudy's just jumping you, looking for the hole, but they're out of there. See you later, Z-Freak.
Yep. If they, they're too scared of the black hole to try and fight, then they'll just get pickoffs. And, Nouns, they're beginning to lose some ground here. It feels like these team fights are harder and harder to execute, and they were already having issues before.
One upside is they're finding a decent amount of farm on Kunkka and Alk, which, I mean, Alk always finds farm, but this bot's build is paying off in the long term. My big question is it going to be enough to combat the extra net worth that these wildcard supports can bring? Because this Wyvern can scale like an absolute beast this game.
Yeah.
I mean, I actually think he should go Ags here. I think it's insanely broken on this hero. I think even on a... He's basically the four of this game. Even on a four Wyvern, you can get it pretty fast. You just become an absolute monster, and it's so tough for Alk to deal with in the late game fights. Kunkka as well. It gives you extra move speed, it gives you mobility in the fight. It's not just a damage item, it makes you tanky and survivable, harder for the Weaver and Tiny to get on top of you. I actually think it's a very considerable item on some of these support Wyverns that maybe we'll see it more in the future, but I don't know if Sammy Boy's gonna think about it. He's more of like, you know, he plays for the team.
Drops the ward, Sam. He's not going to see the Weaver sneaking up on him until it's perhaps too late. Z-Freak's going to be able to follow that up, and they burst down Sam before any spells could go off. Hookshot coming in, trying to stop the unstable concoction, but it was already thrown out, stunning up Divine Llama. Boat coming in, doesn't hit the Necrophos. They want to be able to kill this guy. That way, Gunner's a little bit more free.
He
has no Shroud. He's going to be chain stunned pretty easily. Looks like right-hand side. I don't even know what that avalanche was being thrown at. Maybe he was I think it might have been actually a... I think he was trying to catch the Slardar blinking on him. We'll take that.
Could have been. He could have also just been farming that small camp.
In the river?
Someone dragged it out, I don't know. It's probably for the Slardar potential blink. I like it. Think ahead. Never know.
It's a cute idea.
So, now I'm striking back here with the Alk Networth just punishing this Necro. And,
Ooh.
A hookshot.
Does manage to find him. Eve.
Don't even need it.
They're going to be able to get the bashes with the BKB out.
Maybe
Costa
they do need
might
it.
Be able to live. Shallow Grave, Winter's Curse, actually not going to be able to pull in Costa, but will still group them up. A good stun follow-up there from the Slardar. Starts leading into Z-Freak. There's the black hole onto the two. They're going to start focusing on Gunner, but Gunner is not going down so easily. He's going to pop the BKB, turn around, kill the Slardar, chase after Rudy next. Move somehow, gets off his ultimate. Reaper Scythe finish off the Tiny. Back over to Rudy, though, as he is finally corralled in space by Gunner and Moo. Finish him off. Necrophos.
Boy, Al.
Yeah.
Showed up to the party.
It didn't matter if you had that black hole. With the Chemical Rage, it seemed like, and the AC that he has, he just didn't take enough damage.
This Alec is just dragging him through these fights, man. He's doing so much damage. No one's able to bring him down. I mean, at some point, your Slardar has to man up on this guy, either in a hole or in a stun, like something. And it's just not happening. This Slardar is, okay, he's getting on a Tiny, which Tiny doesn't even die that fast because he has the natural bonus armor. He's getting Shadow Waved, he's getting Grave. By the time all of this goes down, Slardar has no BKB. And then he's getting exploded some random crap. I mean, Eves has got to find a way to have larger impact in these fights. Either start by picking off some support, set up for a curse with the frontline vision, or just be able to man fight this Alchemist. And I think we're a long ways away from that. This Alc is pretty jacked now.
And perhaps gives a little bit of legitimacy to the minus build you're talking about. I think it's hard for Slardar to, I mean, obviously he can't keep up with an Alchemist, but he can't keep up with most cores because he just doesn't have the best farming mechanisms compared to other carries. Alex is going to be spotted here. Chain stun down. Nobody's planning to try and save him. Divai Llama is trying to finish up Ashivas and BKB. I mean, this game has turned pretty significantly, and I think it's something that neither one of us really saw coming. It felt like they had the answers to the Alchemist, but big enough net worth, I guess, solves all problems.
I think they were in a decent position. I think the second Roche should have been theirs based on them controlling the map and everything. This Alc is strong, but honestly, now it's just, they just found the better fights. They found the initiations, set the fights up properly, and again, Dazzle may be causing some issues here. It stops an aggressive Reaper, it stops an aggressive hole. Rudy, flirting with danger.
They walked into each other. Rudy thinks, okay, maybe I can actually kill the Tiny, but no, Gunner shows himself, so he just BKB TPs out. Shard was given to the Weaver, by the way, so we have that upgraded Swarm.
That's very nice. It's something that's going to help this Alc a lot in the fight, too. We're talking about Moo's impact this game. It's come alive a little bit, and this Bugs is doing a lot of work. It's pretty annoying for these wildcard cores to hit it. They don't want to spend the attacks hitting this crap, and at the same time, if you ever get stunned by Alc while this Bug's on you, you're getting 3 or 4 shot. They really need this Slardar AC. It's a huge item in this game. He's a long ways away. The road is steep. And
yes,
paved
it is.
With the corpses of your past mistakes.
The corpses of your past mistakes. Gracious. Rudy
has no BKB.
Yeah, he's got to be a little bit careful. Oh, when he gets caught by the Avalanche. They threw the ward up in the high ground. The blink forward, Avalanche onto two. The toss back into his death. Alex is also going to be a freebie. So great initiation from Z-Freak. Great smoke move, most importantly, from Nouns as a whole.
And he's finding the openings. Making him pay. They definitely cannot fight the Aegis here.
No.
The way their lineup functions is, you know, all inning with these big ults. Aegis just defies all that. It will mean Gunner gets to 6 slot himself and maybe 7 slots. There's no limit to the Alchemist greed.
Dark light. Maybe a overwhelming blink. Illusion. Don't think there's too many good Aghanim Scepters he could give away. Maybe one to the Weaver.
Oh, you give it to the Daz Man. You give it to the Daz Man, then he refreshes all your items.
That's true, yeah.
You make him your slave. You say, follow me.
I mean, the funny part is, I assume it refreshes Lincoln's too.
Refreshes everything.
Imagine a Dazzle refresh. that refresh on the Lincolns that prevents the Reaper's Scythe.
Oh. You get a Reddit thread for sure.
Yeah.
That's what we're all here for, so I hope they do it.
Alright, well, 2 minutes left on the Aegis. Let's go.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Where do you want to go?
Well, I thought we were going high ground, but apparently not.
Why go high ground when you can Grievel's greet it up? He's got the ags queued. Someone's getting it.
Well, it's Weaver? Not the Weaver. Weaver is completing his own Aghanim Scepter.
True.
Oh, holy the toss back. They already have the Cold Embrace on it, but there is going to be Chain Stun. The Torrent Boat is coming in. They need something to be able to dissuade this. The Ul Scepter is going to help out. Now he can go into his ethereal form, so he's okay.
He's X.
But he's pulled back again, and still no curse, no nothing.
How was there no curse there? Was he TPing back? They were so clumped on that go.
Yeah, Sam... well, I mean, Sam was definitely there at the end.
Yeah, he might have not been there in time, but... damn, that would have been a curse right there. I think he could have got three or four. I mean, Nouns have to think about it. This is the way they lose a fight, is the clump into curse, which will set up the hole. Because again, there is no BKB hole cancel, so if you catch three in a curse, you're getting three-man black hole. It's going to be a rough time for you. Nullifier on this Kunkka. Necro's like even harder.
Radiant's top tower has
Gunner is going to town.
Inside of the Midnight Pulse, he doesn't give a damn. Out with the Aegis in tow.
Radiant's top
Don't you wish you could embrace your buildings here?
Yeah, yeah. Radiant's top barracks. Apparently That's they're just going to let him die. Radiant's in exchange for the Aegis. 25 seconds, Radiant's Gunner. Doesn't want to die inside of the enemy base. Doesn't want to risk that. Wildcard are going to go for a smoke out. I assume they're trying to time it and position themselves to catch Nouns as the Aegis expires.
Not a bad idea. Sometimes people are a bit lazy about it. Nouns being pretty disciplined here, though. They're just holding their high ground ward. X and Gunner in.
Oh, Slardar.
He finds the Weaver.
Yeah, found an opening, but the Weaver is actually pretty tanky with the Lotus Orb especially. They start backing up. A self-stun on the Alchemist, not gonna jump. You know, one of these times, don't they have a Yule Scepter? One of these times, I wanna see them try and Yule's catch these X marks the spot plays.
It's pretty hard, unless the Kunk is kind of bad about it, you know? It just lasts too long. You can always play around it.
Yeah,
8 seconds. You never know, though. You might catch him sleeping. So the Slardar did go Moonshard over AC. Higher single target damage output. Though I still feel this AC was a very pivotal item in this game with how much armor differential this Weaver Alk Dazzler creating.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
I mean, now they really need to get that single target burst to start the fight. And if that guy gets graved, you're gonna need a big black hole.
Weaver was given the Aghanim Scepter, so he got the refund and will go for an Aether Lens and I guess maybe like a Blink Dagger or something. I kind of like Blink just to enable the Ags even more.
Really? They just refunded him?
Yeah.
Interesting.
I guess he wanted
it. I would have given it to somebody else, but...
Horse Staff out. Gunner jumps forward and does manage to catch Divine Llama. Cold Embrace.
Nullified.
Yeah, the Nullifier is going to be a problem, and there's just no spells that can be cast to save him. Oof.
Rough position. Very rough. I don't know how you kill his Alk at this point. He's a menace. Your Necro can just not engage the fight. There's too many tossbacks. Like you said, this Weaver has Blink Aether now with the refund. But even if you do manage to try and kill him, there's two saves.
Yeah, the X and the time lapse.
You can bounce this guy all over, man.
Yep, and they don't have to worry about the side lanes ever. Costa's dealing with those.
All right, big smoke wrap. This is the game on the stand in Rudy. He has refresher, double hole. Gotta find the back line here.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Their ward insta dies though. And Mu is just going in.
Yep, Sam, he's gonna have to cold embrace himself, but it's a one-man black hole. That is not what you wanted to be able to save out of this. With the shallow grave going out, Mu's gonna be able to time-lapse himself back up to full. A buyback from Sam. Another attempt, perhaps a winner's curse, a second black hole, perhaps, but it's gonna be able to catch two, but the winner's curse at the same time. What a disaster! Gunner, Reaper, Scythe during the curse! What is going on? Wildcard fumbling through their keyboards and instantly calling the GG. Yeah, a pure shame. What an absolute clusterfuck.
That actually looked pretty decent too, I think.
I cannot believe that just happened.
That is very unfortunate. Sammy Boy has nobody to blame but himself on that one though. That was a curse well after that hole was in motion.